This video will discuss how to calculate depreciation using the units of activity method. We will use this information to illustrate this method. Useful life can be expressed in ways other than a time period. Under the units of activity method, the life of an asset is expressed in terms of the total units of production, or the use expected from the asset, such as miles driven or machine hours. The formula for the units of activity depreciation is the cost minus the salvage value divided by the estimated life in units multiplied by the actual units of activity. Calculating depreciation under the units of activity method is similar to straight line. The only difference is that the life is expressed in terms of an activity rather than years. Under this method, a company estimates the total units of activity for the entire useful life and divides that amount into the depreciable cost to determine the depreciation cost per unit. It then multiplies the depreciation cost per unit by the units of activity during the year to find the annual depreciation expense for that year. In this example, the depreciable cost is $12,000, and that is found by taking the cost of $13,000 and subtracting the salvage value of $1,000. The estimated useful life of this asset is 100,000 miles, so the depreciation cost per unit is 12 cents. If this company drives the truck 15,000 miles in the first year, depreciation expense will be $1,800, and that is found by taking the depreciation cost per unit of 12 cents and multiplying that by 15,000 miles. Using this method, the amount of depreciation reflects the activity that took place during that period. If you look at the first 2 years, the delivery truck was driven twice as many miles in the second year as it was in the first year, and depreciation expense is twice as much in the second year than it was in the first year. The journal entry to record depreciation expense in the first year is a debit to depreciation expense for $1,800 and a credit to accumulated depreciation for the same amount. The last thing I want to mention is that just like in the other methods, depreciation stops when the asset's book value equals its expected salvage value.